So I'm going to use the same buffer system with this one. But this time we're adding HCl. So if we're adding an acid to a buffer system, we would expect the pH to be less than what we started with. So the first thing you have to do is the stoichiometry. So HCl is going to dissociate completely as a strong acid when it gets in solution. So if we start with 0.1 moles of HCl, we get 0.1 moles of H plus. So if we look in our equation, there is H plus in our equation, so I'm going to write the equation next. So the acid that we add is going to react with the acetate part of our equation. So you'll see that I flipped it just so you kind of look at it from a reactance concept. So we have originally 1 mole of this, and we have 1 liter of it. So I'm going to do molarity times the volume to get moles. And the reason I'm doing that is because moles react. So in the stoichiometry, we have a mole react. So that's going to give me 1.0 moles. Again, it's just because both of those are 1. You'll see in the next problem that's not always that case. The H3O plus, we know it's 1 mole of gaseous, so we can just add 0.10 moles of that. And then the same thing for the acetic acid. We had 1 mole, or 1 molar times 1 liter, which is going to give us, again, 1 mole of acetic acid. So we're going to do the stoichiometry. So if we react these, the hydronium is going to be the limiting reactant. So we're going to do minus 0.10. So all of that is going to get used up in the buffer. So again, it takes all of the acid. But in order to do that, I have to use up 0.1 mole of my acetate. So that's going to leave me with a final volume of 0.9 moles. And then it's going to create, so you see kind of that ice chart idea, but again, this is a stoichiometry, so we're using moles instead of molarity, so this is going to be 1.1 moles. Now, when we put it into the equation, we need to factor in that concentration idea. So, notice they tell you the volume of the solution doesn't change, so we know that that is going to be the same. So we're going to divide that by our 1 liter. Now, dividing by 1 liter isn't going to change anything. It's going to be molarity, but again, it's just because these are all in 1 liter of solution. So we go into our pH equals pKa plus the log of the base minus the acid. I'm going to have my pH equal to 4.74, again, still the pKa, or the negative log of 1.8 times 10 to the negative 5, plus the log of the base. Now, I'm just careful this time, the base is written first, so you still have to look at what the base is. So the acetate is the one that can accept the proton, and my acid is acetic acid over 1.1 molar. So again, notice we're back to concentrations going into this equation. Okay. When you sum up for that, you get 4.65. And that makes sense because we added an acid, so we would expect our pH to go down because we've added acid. And again, because it's a buffer, it only changed a very small amount. It changed a whole pH unit. So normally this would change it. If it was not a buffer, this would change it by a pH of 1, so the negative log of 0.1 is 1, so we'd expect 1 full unit of pH change, but the buffer prevents that big change in pH.